Hi everyone, this is Billy. If you have been watching my hydroponics videos, you know that I've started planting this passive growth tube or growth tray hydroponics using the cracky method. I've been creating Otto water level controllers for the trays, but today I want to solve the problem. How can we put an Otto water level controller into this passive growth pipe? Because it is so small and it's all sealed, you can't open it up again to put in your flow rod. Well, you can still achieve a certain degree of automation with the inverted water bottle. You can keep a water level at a decided level with the water bubbling down when that level is lowered. Water is used up. But if you're going out for a holiday for a few weeks, this small bottle will not be able to sustain all the nutrient needs of your plants. This week I've created the Otto water level controller. Yeah, that's the Tjoints PVC pipe. On the right, that's our Otto water level controller that can fit into this small opening of the growth pipe, yet it can control and stop water flow when the water is above the low water mark. And you can connect it to your big nutrient tank that can sustain the water or nutrients for months. This is the Otto water level controller that I made, and I put in some plants. In a few weeks, I will be able to harvest. I have been trying to find a water level controller for this passive grow pipe. However, the ones I can find on the market are really too big. You cannot fit inside the hole because it's so big. Yes, there are those you can install externally and put a pipe into the growth pipe. However, I find it's still too big to be placed outside of the growth pipe, and it will occupy precious space that can be used by my plants. So I intended to create one myself. The first thing you will need is some pill boxes. Just need three of them. You will be cutting up into two halves, and you only need to keep the top one and the bottom one. The middle one will be broken as you cut it across. But make sure you don't damage the top and the bottom one, because we will need them to create our float valve. So you stick the smaller ends together. That will create a long float valve with enough lever system tools to amplify the force, the float valve's floating force, and create enough pressure to stop the water flow when the inlet jet hits the top of the float valve. And we'll be placing a silicone film here, 2 millimeter thick, that will create a cushion between the different cracks on the bottom of the inlet pipes. Make sure you drill a hole at the bottom of this flow valve, and you can insert a pick or a bamboo stick around 4 millimeter thick. Make sure it can freely move. Next, you need to find this PVC T-joint of the size 25 millimeters. Once you find it, you need two, right? Cut one end to a T-shape like this. Drill two holes at the bottom. You must have enough space to fit the flow valve in, and it can move freely up and down. Make sure you can also put in the bamboo stick loose on one end but need to be tight on the other end so it can be fastened in place. Otherwise, use some glues to fix it. Make sure it can move freely after you insert the flow valve into the T-joint. Next, you need to drill a hole close to one side of the T-joint. So a balloon stick that is used to hold the balloons can be used as the inlet pipe. The reason we choose balloon stick is it is hard enough, you won't bend easily, but it's easy to find. You cut one end sharp so you can easier for you to insert the pipe, the rubber pipe. One end of the tube, make sure it's flat so it will be able to seal the water flow. Pressed against the lifted flow valve like this, make sure it's flat so there will not be major cracks. Even find this type of 2 millimeter thick silicone tapes. A piece out of that, just big enough to cover the top of the flow valve, but not too big, otherwise it will block the motion of the flow valve. Silicone tape that I'm using is sticky on both sides, so I need to make sure the top side is not sticky, otherwise it will hold onto the inlet pipe and water will never come out. So I'll need to place it with my thumb to make it dirty so it will not be sticky. It will be better if you can find the silicone tape that is sticky on one side only. So the other side is still soft enough that you can use to press against the inlet to stop water flow. Test it to make sure it's not sticky and it's flat. You will leave a mark on the tape, but that's okay. Next, and the most important step, is to fit the inlet pipe into the T-joint. You need to fit it in an angle and length such that it is having a right angle to the flow valve all the time from all angles. If you don't have the right angle, chances are there will be cracks and you can't stop the water flow from the inlet even though the flow valve has been raised to the very top. So take your time, check it out at all angles, do your own testing. You'll find that the silicone film may be squeezed, so even though you adjust it now, it may fall down again, so make sure you give it a bit more tension. So make sure the right angle is there, and then you can have the hot glue gun to fix it in place. Test it again, make sure it's right angle at every side, because there's some time between the glues harden, so there's still some time you can adjust the angle. Here is how you fit this flow valve into the tiny hole of the groove pipe. So slide it in and make sure you turn it so the flow valve will lie flat on the base of the groove pipe. Yep, here you are, you've created your flow valve, but don't stop here yet. You need to do a water test first to make sure your flow valve doesn't leak. Otherwise, your groove pipe will be flooded very soon. Okay, this is how we start the test. We'll look at the level of the ruler there. Wait until it stabilizes. If it doesn't stabilize after 10 or more minutes, that means you have a trouble. Your flow valve is leaking. So once water is stabilized, You can try to use the pump to pump away the water and see whether water starts flowing again. Otherwise, your balloon stack will be stuck with the silicone.